Hi guys, this is Vaish from Vaish IAS. Again, we are going to continue our Geography NCERT series, and class 6th we are doing, and we have done till chapter 6, and this is the last video of class 6. That is, we have a total of 8 chapters, 6 are done, 2 we'll be doing today, and we will be ending class 6th and immediately starting class 7th. Okay, so our aim is to complete all the NCERTs with minimum time. Okay, that is why all my videos are very fast. If you see, I'm reading out very fast, reading out only important points, because NCERTs from 6th to 12th we'll be doing. Obviously from 9th standard only more detailed information will come. Up to then it's just familiarizing with the topic, like what is mountain, what is latitude, what is forest, basic definitions only. So we don't have to grasp much here, just going through the pictures and doing away with the series. Okay, so let's start chapter 7. Please download the PDFs, I'm telling it in every video. And the Facebook page link was there in the slide, first slide, I forgot to tell you. Just like that page and turn on the notification so that you can solve the MCQs which we post daily. All are UPSC standard MCQs, okay. So 7th and 8th chapter is basically about India. So we see some geography, some animals, plants, all those things about India, okay. So chapter 7 is telling about the geographical regions. The Himalayas are there in the north, Arabian Sea in the west, Bay of Bengal in the east, Indian Ocean in the south, and everything has its own importance, and UPSC can frame question from anywhere, okay. Himalayas, the disaster management related thing, Arabian Sea because of the cyclone, Bay of Bengal because of the cyclone, Indian Ocean because of the monsoon system, okay. Everything is important. We'll see it in detailed way in different chapters and different classes, okay. The peninsula is a piece of land that is surrounded by water on three sides. So India is actually a peninsula, okay. Any other peninsula, you know, like we have an Iberian Peninsula, which is the regions around Portugal and Spain in Europe, Western Europe, you can tell that is Iberian Peninsula. So there are a lot of peninsulas. UPSC can ask you to arrange it from west to east, or things mapping we'll do separately someday, okay. So India's area, Kashmir, Kanyakumari, these are all we don't need, the statistics we don't need at all. Indian deserts, northern plains, plateaus, so India has almost every kind of landforms. Second most populous country of the world after China. So this is one statistic. And another thing, recently a migration report has come, global migration report, and in that it is told like Indians are the ones who migrate the maximum. Okay, so the maximum migration happens from India, people going from India to outside, okay. India is first there, but population India is second. So remember such things which is there in the news. Location based on the latitudes and longitudes. Tropic of Cancer passes through the Indian map, if you know. I'll show you the map after some time. So these are the latitudes, 8 degree to 37 degree north. Okay, both are north, okay. We are in the northern hemisphere. Similarly, we are in the eastern hemisphere, 8 and 37 and 68 and 97. Both the things, if you see, 30 degree, almost 30 degree gap is there, whether it be latitude wise or longitude wise, okay. And this longitude, you know, that is why we have a standard meridian, because the time will keep on change. As per the Greenwich Meridian system, whatever is there west of Greenwich Meridian, we have to add these many hours. That is, for every 1 degree, you have to add 4 minutes, or 15 degree, you have to add 60 minutes. We have seen this in the previous video, I'm just repeating it. So India, because of the 30 degree gap, it will have almost 2 hours of gap, but still we have only one timeline. China, US, sorry, Russia, US and all, they have multiple timelines. And Indian standard time, which is a single one, passes through somewhere, it will be somewhere here, through UP, through Allahabad it will go, through 5 states it will go. The trick to remember the 5 states I will tell you in some other video. And there's also a trick to remember the Tropic of Cancer states also. There are 8 states actually. I will show you a different map where it will be much more clear. This is the political map. So if you see, the Tropic of Cancer is passing through Gujarat, small portion of Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Tripura and Mizoram, okay. So you should know 8 states are there. There is a trick, simple trick to learn all these 8 states. I'll teach you some other day. We have a CTS series specially for learning tricks alone, okay. So Indian standard time and the Tropic of Cancer, I'll tell you the trick later. Please wait for that series. Political and administrative divisions. This is actually a very good map NCERT has provided, where you can see all the great mountains, the ranges, the rivers, the valleys, plateaus, everything is there. It's a very interesting map also. I'll tell you one thing about this Indus River. Indus River, if you see, we know five tributaries are there: Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias, and Satluj. Okay, but it is not like all these rivers are directly going and joining the Indus. Okay, you should know the actual way how it is formed, this map, because Indus River is very much in the news, especially because now I think 2 days before there was a news of the project UJH. UJH, okay, project UJH. They are trying to use the water of Ravi more efficiently in India, okay, because you know the Indus Water Treaty, which happened in 1960 after the partition of India and Pakistan. Indus, Jhelum and Chenab is allotted to Pakistan. Ravi, Bias and Satluj is allotted to India. If you see, bigger rivers are there given to Pakistan, and it is even called the most generous treaty ever happened, okay, generous in favor of Pakistan. India did not, at that time, Nehru's failed policies, you can call one of the failed policy. So issues often happen, so that is why you should know the mappings, okay. So getting back to the topic, so if you see, Chenab is actually one of the longest tributary, you can call, which actually goes like this, and Jhelum is coming and joining it, Ravi is coming and joining it, Satluj is coming and joining it, okay. Now you will think, where is Bias? Bias is actually rising in India and ending in India itself. It will go and actually join the Satluj somewhere here, okay. It is not even going to Pakistan. The other four, if you see, it's all going to Pakistan also, but Bias will be starting in India and ending in Satluj itself, within India, okay. So you should know such facts. UPSC can frame statements. And the origin, if you see, all these tributaries are originating from India only, but Satluj is coming from somewhere near this Mount Kailasha, which is in Tibet, okay. So somewhere there Satluj will be starting, Indus also will be starting there, the main Indus River. But the other four tributaries, Jhelum from somewhere in Jammu, Chenab, Ravi, Bias somewhere in Himachal, okay. Exact places we'll see when we learn the river system, okay. I just went into detail now just to give you an idea how much we have to learn, or what we have to learn in terms of geography, because class 6 textbook, you will be just going through the pages. I'll be going very fast. But we will be seeing everything, all the rivers, all the tributaries, the these ranges, the Vindhya range, Satpura range, Western Ghats, Coastal Plains, everything in detail we'll see, don't worry. So class 6 is just a overview. Union Territories is Telangana and 29 states, you know, before this we had Uttarakhand, Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh forming in 2000. So states keep forming, because India, you know, it can be broken down into as many states as want. That is allowed, but union cannot be broken. That is the polity part, we will see later. Alluvial deposits, these are very fine soils brought by rivers and deposited in the river basin. So you know the plains are formed like that only, from rivers, sorry, from mountains. Rivers will come down carrying all the silt and deposits, and then it will come and settle in the plains or the mountain basin. That is how alluvial plains are formed. Tributary, I told you in the last video also, somewhere it will originate, but it will come and join the main river. That is tributaries. Distributaries is the opposite, where river will split into multiple small rivers. Physical divisions, so here they are telling about the Himalayas. Him is actually snow, the abode of snow, that means the house of snow is Himalaya, okay, Him plus Alaya. Great Himalaya or Himadri, that's the topmost one, in that picture also it was there. Middle Himalaya or Himachal, then southern one is Shivalik, or maybe lesser Himalayas you can call, or inner Himalayas, where it is inside or more close to the Indian main landmass, okay. So Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik, that is the order. Then Indian plains are there, like we told, the rivers will come and deposit Ganga, Brahmaputra, Indus. Great Indian deserts are there in the western part, where it is dry, hot and sandy. Peninsular plateau, one of the oldest region, the Deccan plateau, volcanic traps are all there. Aravalli Hills is one of the oldest range of the world, okay, not only India, of the world itself, oldest range. Vindhya, Satpuras, Narmada Tapi river is actually flowing through there. We'll see in detail, don't worry now that we are not going in detail of each and everything. Vindhyas is there, Satpura is there, in between that Narmada is there, and Tapi river is below Satpura. So the order is Vindhya, Narmada, Satpura and Tapi, okay. Like there are multiple river systems are there. If we start going into detail each of these things, then we cannot complete the NCERTs. Now just understand the basic story. Western Ghats is also called as Sahyadris, it's a term, okay, you should know. Eastern Ghats provide, Eastern Ghats in the eastern boundary. Then these things, differences between Western Ghats and Eastern. Western Ghats are continuous, okay, almost continuous. There will be passes to pass through it, mountain passes. We know the Thal Ghat, Pal Ghat, Bor Ghat, there are many things across Maharashtra, Bombay, Kerala and all. Eastern Ghats are broken and uneven, okay. The plateau is rich in minerals like coal and iron ore. So the eastern side, we have already seen the Chota Nagpur plateau and all those things where minerals are there. Coral islands. What are corals? Corals are, it's actually an environment topic, but it's covered here. Corals are skeletons of tiny marine animals called polyps. When the living polyps die, their skeletons are left. Other polyps grow on top of their hard skeleton, which grows higher and higher, thus forming the coral islands. Lakshadweep is actually a coral island. Okay, it's formed like this. Tiny marine animals called polyps. Skeletons are left, which rise to islands when they are found in lot of like groups. Eastern coastal islands, sorry, coastal plains are much broader. Okay, the western is actually narrow and eastern is actually broader. You know the area near Visakhapatnam and all, there it is broader, but western side near Goa and all, it is narrower. Okay, so number of eastern flowing rivers are there. Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, these are all eastern flowing rivers. Okay, that means it will go and end in the Bay of Bengal, not in the Arabian Sea. And they form fertile deltas at the mouth. The Sundarban Delta is formed where the Ganga and Brahmaputra flow in the Bay of Bengal. That's actually the biggest delta in the world also. Then these are all not required. Islands, Lakshadweep and Andaman, you know. Lakshadweep is in the Arabian Sea. It's a coral island. It's in news because of the Oki cyclone. Andaman and Nicobar Islands also in news because yesterday or day before yesterday, I think the Narcondam hornbill, which is which is present in the Narcondam Island in Andamans. Okay, so these kind of things, when there are news, definitely UPSC will form a question. So try to relate everything you read to current affairs. Basic MCQs just for revising this chapter, nothing related to UPSC. The southernmost Himalayas are called Shivaliks. Okay, Sahyadris are also known as Western Ghats. The Park Strait lies between the countries India and Sri Lanka. The Indian islands in the Arabian Sea, Arabian Sea means western side, is known as Lakshadweep Islands. Andaman is in the Bay of Bengal and Maldives is little more south towards the like Indian Ocean, you can call it. Oldest mountain range in India is Aravalli. Aravalli is actually among the world also, it's one of the oldest. Okay, so this is chapter 7. Let's go and finish chapter 8 also quickly. That is also related to India. So let's see what is there in chapter 8. I think it is about the tropical forest and the flora, fauna. The it's more of environment topic, like we have the sanctuaries or the wildlife reserves and all. Some names only, so you know, classics textbook, so we'll see quickly what is there. So it's beginning with weather and climate concept. Weather, you know, like we ask each other like, how is the weather today? So it is like day to day change. It's not a season or it is not a long term climatic condition. Okay, weather is just how it is when you look outside the window, how do you feel, that is weather. Okay, temperature, rainfall, sunshine, these kind of determinants are there. Detriments are there, which decides that hot, cold, sunny, cloudy, windy, calmy, these kind of basic things, that is all weather. Okay, major seasons in India, cold weather, that is the winter season, you can call. Our winters are not anyway like the USA and all, where we have snowfall in across India, but we have a cold season anyway, December to February. Now when we are recording this video, now it is the time of winter. Okay, everywhere it's very cold. Hot weather season or summer season, March to May. Then southwest monsoon, the most important one, we learn detail in multiple chapters in multiple classes, June to September. Then season of retreating monsoon, where the winds will be actually returning from the land to the sea. Okay, so that is in October, November, or the autumn season, you can call it, comparing with the global standards. Now just one line about this thing, winter season, sun rays do not fall directly in the region. Okay, do not fall. Temperatures are quite low in northern India, like Delhi and all, we know in winter how it is. So in the hot weather season, more or less directly fall in the region. Okay, so here is direct, here is not direct. And one, this actually UPSC asked once, like what is loo, a match the following question, something was asked. So temperature becomes very high, hot and dry winds called loo blow during the day. So during the daytime, hot, dry winds, all the three things you should know. It is hot, it is dry, and it is during the daytime. Okay, UPSC will purposely put it as night to confuse you. Okay, so remember that. Then southwest monsoons or the rainy season, again same thing, winds will be carried from the Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal towards the land. They'll carry that much moisture, so that will result in the heavy rainfall which occurs in India. Okay, the El Nino conditions and all are there, in which case the things will not turn out so fruitfully, and then we'll have the drought season. That is a different thing, we'll learn later. El Nino season of retreating monsoon or autumn, again like the winds are going back, and this is the time when Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh actually receive rainfall. Okay, that is almost during after monsoon, you can call it, when the winter is beginning or autumn is beginning, that is when Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh has lot of rainfall. However, the climate is about the average weather condition which have been measured over many years. So that is climate, which is not short term, which is a little bit of long term. The monsoon word is an Arabic word from the word Mausim. Okay, we have Project Mausim, where India has launched related to the climate and culture and all, connecting the regions across the Arabian Sea. That is we learn when we learn schemes, Project Mausim. The climate of a place is affected by its location, altitude, distance from the sea, relief. So these are four important factors which will decide a particular climate. Okay, India is actually located very beautifully and it has almost every kind of climate. Okay, like if you see the differences, Jaisalmer and Bikaner in Rajasthan has deserts, very hot deserts. Dras and Kargil. Dras is actually the second most coldest place in the world. Okay, not India, in the world. Okay, minus 40, minus 60, that much temperature will go down. Okay, Dras. Kargil, you know, the Siachen Glacier, you know, our army men are there, they are even stationed there during that kind of extreme weather conditions. That is why we should respect our army. You can see photographs across internet, or if you have a chance to go visit Ladakh or Leh, please visit. Not during the extreme winters, anyway roads will be closed at that time, but try to go in August, September, or that time. You can even meet the army men, they will be very delighted to actually meet you people. Okay, once they get a group of tourists or someone who is coming there, they will tell all their stories, their war related thing or many things. Okay, I have experienced it personally, that's why I'm telling. Meet the army personnel, it's a very, what is a pleasant feeling or the most beautiful feeling you will ever have. So try to go and meet them there, not in not when they come home for vacation. You have to go there and meet them. Coastal places like Mumbai and Kolkata experience a moderate climate. So we have almost every kind of climate, that is the essence of the entire thing. Mausim Ram in Meghalaya is the world's highest rainfall receiving place. Okay, so again, India has places like this, okay, where it is like world's highest, okay, world's oldest mountain, world's highest mountain, world's rainiest place, all these things are there in India. Natural vegetation, so this picture is also very good, like you can see the different levels, like shrubs are the lower levels, then the young trees, then the canopy is something like the tree will be like this, that the sunlight even will not be entering inside. Okay, in evergreen forest and all, it will be there near equators and all, Indonesia and all, most of the trees are like this, the forest area. Okay, that much thick vegetation and canopy will be there. Okay, again same thing, I don't think anything which is needed to be grasped is here. Again, rainfall will decide the forest conditions and all basic things which anyone can answer or anyone will know. Types we'll see, tropical rainforest, this is the picture, like I told, canopy, you can't see the earth, okay, sunlight can't enter, that much it is, like in Jungle Book movie and all you can see these kind of things. So here basic things we'll see, sunlight doesn't reach the ground. Many species of trees are found in these forests which shed their leaves at different times. Okay, it's not like it's always like that, it will be shedding at different times, but there will be some trees at least which are always green. So it is like you will be see greenery throughout the year, some will be shedding, some will be available, some will be like other way. So it is always green, that is why evergreen forest. Important trees, UPSC, at least 5 years back they used to keep on ask the math the following questions, or they will give a description like the sun is like this, the climate is like this, and finally you have to tell like which type of forest are we referring to, like a poem they used to give 4-5 line description, a very big question it will be, and then they'll have choice like tropical evergreen, tropical deciduous, moist desert, moist Himalayan, something they'll give. So you have to know description about each of the types of forest. No, mahogany, ebony and rosewood are important trees there. So these are the locations again. Andaman, Nicobar Islands, part of northeast and narrow strip of Western Ghats. The Western Ghats in the South India and the northeast regions, you should know, like they are almost similar in kind of the plantation and forest and all. Okay, even rainfall you can say, most green areas in India. Then this is tropical deciduous forest. So here if you see, less dense compared to the other one, evergreen. They are also called monsoon forest. Okay, so we should not confuse, like the other one is monsoon, this is actually monsoon forest. Okay, and India, this is what is there at maximum, the other one was more in the equatorial region. Okay, so you should know tropical deciduous is more in India and it is monsoon forest. Now these are the tree names, sal, teak, peepal, neem, shisham. Okay, you should know this. States, if you see lot of states, the other one, like it was restricted to just Western Ghats and northeast and also in the Andamans, but here if you see Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Orissa and parts of Maharashtra, entire central India and almost north India, it is there. Okay, These are again pictures of it. So it's like not always evergreen, okay? It can be like this also. So that is why the name is different. Thorny bushes. This type of vegetation is found in dry areas of the country. The leaves are in the form of spines to reduce the loss of water. Cactus, care, bubble, kicker are important plants or trees you can call. Okay, and the regions will be Western India, Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, eastern slope of West Ghat. So western slope of Western Ghats, that is near the sea, it was evergreen. But the eastern slope of Western Ghats, you can see thorny bushes also. Okay, so don't think like Western Ghats doesn't have these kind of thorny bushes. Okay, this is where UPSC picks up statements and then frames questions. And even the coaching institute will tell you like everything is there in NCERT. You'll be reading NCERT, but these kind of statements, please try to focus. So these are again pictures for your understanding. The very, what to say, best thing about NCERT. More than reading, you can see pictures and learn everything. This is mountain vegetation. The wide range of species is found in the mountains according to variation in height. So as the height differs, obviously the plant will differ, the animals will differ. Okay, 2500 meters. Trees are called coniferous trees. So these kind of things, coniferous trees are mountain vegetation. Monsoon forest is tropical deciduous. Okay, so try to remember. Chir, pine and deodar are important in mountain vegetation. Okay, mangrove forest, again your environment topic. These forests can survive in saline water, found mainly in the Sundarbans. Sundarbans is the Ganga Brahmaputra delta. Also in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Okay, so Andaman and Nicobar is also very, very important with respect to vegetation. Sundari tree is there, well-known species. That is why it is called Sundarbans, named after that. Okay, so here one interesting thing is there. When a child is born, a tree is planted and all. So try to do these kind of things in life instead of doing the ice bucket challenge or doing fun stuff in social media. For your birthdays and all, try to plant a tree and then post that in Facebook. That will show a better image of you as a person and a citizen of this nation. Okay, for the better world, we have to start promoting that kind of things. Anyway, after becoming IAS officers, we have to promote across the country or wherever we are posted. We have to do these kind of activities. Only then we can bring about some major changes. Okay, behavioral change is the key to a developed India or the new India, which our Prime Minister is talking about, each and every species. Okay, leave that back to topic. Forest, why are forests necessary? No need to read all those things, just see this picture. It has like for every sector, anything, forests are important. Okay, whether it be this kind of a food, shelter, oxygen and all those things, or fodder for animals, fuel, sports items. You know, the cricket bats are formed with a tree, I think a kookaburra tree or something, it is formed, the bark of that. Furniture, medicines, apparels, honey, fruits, vegetables. The tribal people are mostly dependent on this thing. Timber, rubber, okay. So soil binding, the environmental factors also you have to tell. So that is all, you can write it yourself. It's like lot of things are there. Anyway, in detail we'll do in subsequent chapters. Wildlife, we'll see some important national animal. Tiger is the national animal, peacock is the national bird. Then elephants are found in Kerala and Karnataka. Elephants and rhinoceros are found in Assam. Gir forest, Asiatic lions. Wild asses are found in Great Indian Desert and Run of Kutch. Camels are found there. Wild goats, snow leopards, bears, etc. found in the Himalayan region. So India has almost every kind of animal, okay. Common things which are found almost everywhere. Monkeys, wolves, jackal, nilgai, cheetah. Then common bird names are there, not required. This is a good page, like Project Tiger, Project Elephant, you have to learn from Shankar IAS. Project Hangul is there. Hangul is going to be coming under critically endangered soon. That is a recent current affair. Snakes, cobras found in India. Lot of environmental, this all I think environment it will be better, we cover all these things. But see these newspaper cuttings everywhere, you will see different things, like Simlipal is in Orissa. You should know these kind of things. Okay, match the following questions will come. Sariska Tiger Reserve is there in Rajasthan. Then Gir is there in, where it is? It is in Gujarat. So that kind of famous or popular things which comes in the news. Okay, these are old news anyway, but whatever comes in news you have to know. Okay, recently the 50th Tiger Reserve in India was inaugurated somewhere. You have to tell me in comment section where it is, okay. The name I think is Kamlang Tiger Reserve, you have to tell me which state it is. Migratory birds, again in news, Amur falcon, the bird is always in news. It's not mentioned here, but it is in news because it is starting from Siberia and going till South Africa. In between, it will stop at Nagaland. So that is why it is important. It stops in India. There are other birds also here, like Siberian crane is there, pelican is there, stork, flamingo, pintail duck. Okay, many migratory birds visit India, okay, during these different months. Okay, so that is about fauna of India. So we'll see that basic questions. The world's highest rainfall occurs in Mohsindra. Mangroves forest can thrive in saline water. Mahogany and rosewood are in tropical evergreen. Okay, tropical evergreen. The other place, tropical deciduous was, I think neem and all was there. Neem, shisham, teak, that and all was there in deciduous. Wild goats and snow leopards are found in Himalayan region. Okay. During the southwest monsoon period, the moisture laden winds blow from sea to land. Okay, that's how we get the rainfall. So this is chapter 8. So we are done actually with chapter 7 and 8. So please finish it this way. I think all the videos together itself will be 1 hour only. Class 6 is complete. Like this, I'll try to put for everything. Okay. As we proceed to higher classes, obviously video length will little bit like it will be increased because more details you have to learn. But these chapters and all, just do the videos. Don't go and waste your time reading the books. Okay. So till we come up with the next video, thank you and have a nice day.